sticky sidebars offer a sleek and intuitive way to enhance user experience on web pages. Unlike traditional fixed positioning, which keeps elements static regardless of scrolling, sticky sidebars elegantly adhere to the viewport as users navigate up or down the page. This dynamic behavior effortlessly maintains important content within sight, providing seamless access to key information without cluttering the screen. Welcome to today's video. We will be creating a sidebar that sticks to a specific position as the user scrolls through the page. But before we begin, make sure to hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell to stay updated on our front-end development tutorials. Let's get started. In our demo project, we have set up a straightforward layout consisting of a header, a sidebar, and a content area. Our CSS file is also ready with some foundational styles for the body, header, and footer elements. Next, we defined the main HTML element as a grid container with two columns and a gap of 2 rem. The first column, with a fixed width of 200 pixels, serves as our sidebar, while the remaining space is allocated for the content. We then applied basic CSS rules to style the sidebar widgets and typography. However, as it stands, if we scroll down the page, the sidebar behaves like any other element and moves along with the rest of the content. But what if the sidebar contains vital secondary navigation, action items, or filters that need to remain easily accessible as users scroll through the main content? In such cases, we want this sidebar component to stay fixed to the viewport, ensuring it remains contextually accessible regardless of the page's scroll position. Let's address this challenge next. A sticky sidebar is a powerful web design technique that ensures the sidebar remains visible on the screen even as the user scrolls past its initial position. This functionality offers several benefits, such as keeping sub-navigation easily accessible and potentially boosting ad impressions, clicks, and page views. In the past, this functionality was frequently accomplished through JavaScript calculations to detect the scroll position and toggle an element's position to absolute or fixed. However, with the CSS position property, we can achieve the same effect more intuitively. By setting the position to sticky and specifying a directional offset, we can create a sticky sidebar with ease. This snippet ensures that the sidebar sticks to the viewport once it reaches a specific scroll position. In this case, the offset is set to 2 rem from the top edge of the viewport, which can be adjusted depending on design specifications. Despite our initial anticipation, there are a few common scenarios where sticky positioning can fail to produce the desired result. One such case occurs when using flexbox or grid layouts, as we have implemented in our project. Let's see how we can address this issue and ensure our sticky sidebar starts working its magic. In our case, the main element is set as a grid container, effectively making the sidebar a grid item. By default, grid items fill the entire height of their cell. To debug this issue, let's temporarily add a background color to the sidebar. As you can see, the sidebar stretches down to the end of the grid container. This indicates that if the sidebar is already consuming the full height of its parent container, it won't have anything to stick to. To resolve this, we can add a line items start to the grid container. This will position grid items at the beginning of their grid cells. And just like that, our sidebar becomes a sticky sidebar. Now we can safely remove the background color and enjoy the intended behavior. Another crucial point to consider is that the sticky positioning won't function as expected if the parent container has the overflow property set. Specifically, the overflow property must be set to visible, which is the default value. In other words, if the parent container of our sticky element has its overflow property set to hidden, auto, or scroll, the sticky behavior may fail to work. In summary, a sticky element maintains its initial position in the HTML flow until it reaches a specified threshold in the viewport, at which point it sticks in place until it hits the boundary of its parent element. This offset can be controlled by specifying the top, right, bottom, or left directions. Whether used for navigation menus, calls to action, or supplementary content, sticky sidebars strike the perfect balance between accessibility and aesthetics, enriching the browsing journey with their subtle yet impactful presence. If you found this tip helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more exciting tutorials. Thanks for tuning in and see you next time.